Okay.
Rock and roll.
We had been reading about this horrible crisis in Flint, which put thousands of children of the community at risk of being poisoned by lead in the water supply.
You've got citizens who were essentially saying to anyone who would listen, look, my hair is falling out, I have rashes, my children have rashes, we're afraid of this water, the water's discolored, there's something going on here that's unhealthy, we need somebody to pay attention.
We were told by the city that they were winterizing the system, but we had lived here for years at that point. We'd never experienced anything like that.
Leanne Walters was a citizen scientist who learned the science because she had twin boys, and one of her boys was being poisoned by the water, and his growth was being stunted.
Leanne was the one who figured out that her children had been poisoned by the water.
It was the worst lead and water contamination I'd seen in 25 years.
She just began to educate herself to the point where she knew how to ask the questions that she needed to ask of the water authorities and to get answers and really begin to put them on the spot.
People were marching in the streets. They were out of their mind with anger.
Water is a human right! Fight, fight, fight!
The Flint story is a story of how a community was let down by the agencies and the scientists and the engineers that are entrusted with protecting the water supply.
But it's also about how ordinary people within the community, how scientists and also students came together to really expose this problem, which would not have been exposed without their commitment and their courage.